Hi, my name is Brianna Snyder, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi & Associates. This video will cover 5th edition task list items F4 and F7. In this video, I'm going to talk about how you can conduct an ecological assessment via telehealth. When working from home, what kind of environmental manipulations do you make? This may include altering your workspace, eliminating distractions, and implementing new reinforcers for yourself. So, if we as practitioners are making environmental manipulations in our own environment, we should be helping our caregivers and learners make environmental manipulations as well. And just like we would with everything else, we assess. That brings us to the question of, what can we assess? Well, the environment, of course. An ecological assessment acknowledges the interrelationship between the environment and behavior. You can gather information about the learner and the various environments in which that person is in. Other ecological assessments may be conducted across various settings, but for the purpose of telehealth, I'm going to be talking about conducting an ecological assessment within the home. What exactly are we assessing? We can assess physical aspects of the environment, such as lighting, seating arrangements, and noise level. We can examine interactions with others in their environment, such as caregivers, siblings, and other family members. We also want to consider the learner's past reinforcement history. Before we continue, it is important to remember the number one purpose of any assessment is to identify the most urgent behavioral challenge and find potential solutions to reduce it. This also includes figuring out the variables that maintain the behavioral challenge. Before conducting an ecological assessment, you need to know when and how to use it. According to Heron and Heward, 1988, they suggested that we must be able to discriminate between situations in which an intervention has the potential for affecting behaviors other than the target behavior, and situations in which an intervention may be ineffective because of other environmental variables present. If we decide that this is an assessment that we should conduct, how do we do it via telehealth? Let's talk about telehealth for a second. Telehealth is the remote delivery of healthcare through telecommunications technology. When using telehealth for an ecological assessment, the good news is, because you are assessing the environment, minimal interaction is required. But with that being said, it is still important to review the necessary components for the telehealth session with the caregiver. This may include having them prepare the room, setting up the camera ahead of time, and allowing the caregiver to become familiar with any software downloaded to their device for telehealth purposes. When it comes to setting up the camera, have the caregiver place it somewhere in which you can see the learner's environment and how they interact within it. If there is information that is not observable, so a caregiver interview should take place as well. Based on components of FOVL's Structured Ecological Assessment tool and parameters set forth by the Council for Autism Service Providers, here are some components you can assess. Examine the session environment. Look for potential distractions and assess space and lighting. What are the setup arrangements? Is there a current reinforcement system in place, or is the learner receiving free access to preferred items? Consider potential safety hazards. Are there sharp objects for weapons in the home that the learner can easily gain access to? Is the yard fenced in? Do they have a pool or trampoline? Is the furniture stable and secured to the wall when necessary? Are there fragile or breakable items in the session area? Are there pets in the home? If so, how does the learner interact with those pets? Are the doors locked? Do they have an alarm system and is it activated? Environmental planning is another important component to evaluate. Record any locations in which sessions can be conducted, as this could be helpful for programming for generalization across various rooms in the home. Is there enough space for the session? Will the learner initiate the telehealth session independently or with assistance from a caregiver? What does the format of the session look like? Formats could include having the caregiver available for the entire session, having the caregiver within earshot to prompt when needed, or the caregiver is not present at all. Siblings and other family members may participate as well. What are the durations that the learner, caregiver, and other family members are able to sustain a telehealth session? Record any materials that may be required, including any visuals. What type of prompts does this learner require, and is the caregiver able to provide prompts at that level? Consider response formats. Responses may come in various formats, including vocal, written, following directions, point to or touch, making a choice, imitation, and coloring or drawing. Once we assess, what's next? Well, we can use the answers from the assessment to further pinpoint environmental manipulations. Environmental manipulations might be easier for the caregiver to follow through with, rather than asking them to run a formal behavior plan. It will allow for the opportunity for the caregiver to have quick wins and gain some behavioral momentum, eventually building up to running a more formalized behavior plan. Additionally, you can add this to your home program book files for all staff to view. This way, anyone who is conducting a telehealth session will have an understanding of what the environmental arrangements look like, and it can help guide the session. Thank you for watching. For more content regarding telehealth, as well as any other behavior analytic content, please subscribe.